Hey, what's up everybody, my name is TrophyNut and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Today, we're gonna enter the Grand Cathedral, I suppose, from Irritil of the Boreal Valley. And, well, I'm a bit scared because this looks like a boss fight. I can kind of see something behind there. I don't really know what it is, but it looks creepy. The only thing that's here in the sake of messages is, well, let there be ally. And I also want to point out the vista here, because you can see a lot of things from here. If I'm guessing, that should be the Cathedral of the Deep. That big building over there. And that's Lothric Castle, I suppose. That being Lothric Castle, I'm supposing that's the Great Tree where we fought the Cursed Rotten Great Tree. You can actually see a lot of things from here. Which makes me wonder whether you can see this place from anywhere over there, but enough talk. Let's head inside. Pontiff Sulyvahn, yes, that was long overdue. The pontiff of this place, the one responsible for the curse. He doesn't seem to be attacking me just yet. Which makes me wonder how much chance I'm gonna get. Now the music started. It's actually a really nice place. Okay. Let's get in there. He's coming closer. And there's... he has a fire sword. Which is not really handy, is it? The guy can teleport! He has two swords. Oh wow! Two hits! Okay! Huh. So that was something. So the pontiff has, well, clearly has two swords, mainly a fire one and a, well, purple magic one, I'm supposing. I'm wondering if I'm gonna get any benefit from using the great magic weapon. So that's that guy, not leaving anything behind, okay. So I'm gonna run in here. Kill those guys. And then I only have that shield guy, I suppose, if I'm smart about this. Okay, so let's put Great Magic Weapon on, drink an Ashen Estus Flask, and go back in. So his swords aren't lit until he actually comes closer, but the effect is not visible at all. I have a feeling I got a range advantage in this fight. He's really unpredictable in his moveset. Yeah, okay. gonna have to do this a different way. Magic doesn't seem to work, so I'm not gonna even bother. Well, it works, but it just does as much damage as me hitting once with my Uchi Katana in a normal state. Let's heal up fully. And I think my tactic is gonna be a bit more defensive. Dodging, well, it works, but I feel like I'm still way too vulnerable if I try to dodge him. So I can... because I can block his attacks. Oh wow, okay. Okay, if he keeps his distance, I'm gonna... I have a feeling my shield is my best option here. Shit, okay. This looks like it's gonna hurt. There's a copy of him, seriously? Oh wow, I'm out the fastest. I'm gonna die. Yeah. Wow, the copy is annoying. Oh, that's why. Oh shit, dingus and dingus. he's attacking solo now.
Thank you.
in the face! Okay. Pontiff Sulyvahn slayed. Oh my god. Okay, maybe I'm gonna end it with, wow, 50,000 souls. But explaining what the, well, in my opinion, my strategy was. So the first half, I recommend a shield. I highly recommend a shield. Don't think about the tiny amount of damage that he does through your shield, because he can do both fire and dark damage, I think his other sword is. Don't think about that, just block his attacks, and when you see an opening, just slash. Keep that going, heal in between if you're below half health, but you can block pretty much everything. When you're past that, if you're either, if he transforms, so he gets that weird haircut, try to keep your distance, because he has an area effect around him. As long as the transformation is going, that damages you constantly. So try either, if you're at low health, heal at that moment, or use one of your ranged attacks. When he's transformed, go in immediately. Because once he's transformed, he won't attack until he creates that doppelganger. The doppelganger is a real bitch, but try to keep your distance. If you keep your distance, they only have a few attacks they can do. They have a few magic attacks. The beam attack is easily dodged to the left or to the right. If they go up into the air, you should be able to dodge left to right twice, because they copy each other's attacks. So if you see the copy do an attack, it's highly, very likely that the original Pontiff will do the exact same attack a second in between. Anything else? So keep your distance, and if you have a ranged attack, that's what I would use, because he kind of dodges them, but most soul arrows just follow the path. And as an extra bonus, if you use magic, the copy is highly susceptible to magic. If you hit it with two of those heavy soul arrows, I think it dies. And if you manage that, I haven't managed it, but because it was really focused on the original. If you manage that, he'll have to stop attacking you and try to make another copy again, which gives you another moment to slash away at his original health bar. He also has a lot less combo attacks as he has in the first phase. But it's still not a good idea to keep close, because even if he only has a 2 combo, his copy does the exact same thing, so you get 4 attacks into your face either way. So, I'm gonna check out the soul. I don't think I got anything else. There seems to be a door behind there, although it even looks like a mirror of some kind. But I'm gonna check out Pontiff Sulyvahn's soul. Over here. Used to acquire many souls. Pontiff Sulyvahn of Irritil imprisoned a god of the old royalty in the abandoned cathedral to be fed to the devourer. Okay, so that's how he got his powers. He imprisoned a god. A god of the old royalty. Interesting. But I'm not gonna continue yet because of, well, I have 50,000 souls in my inventory. I would be crazy if I continue now. So let's light the bonfire. And then I'm gonna warp to Firelink Shrine first. As we do after a boss fight. So travel to Firelink Shrine. Firekeeper sitting on the stairs again. There doesn't seem to be anything here, so
welcome
there
home,
we go. Welcome home.
Very
let's
well.
Level up. And then let's put 1 in strength. That should allow me to use that wolf's blade. And then for the rest, I'll probably put 1 in dexterity. And maybe even 1 in vitality, because that ups my equipment load, doesn't it? I would want to, but then again, I don't really, so I might as well go further into dexterity to boost my output, because health is always less important in a Dark Souls game than is your output. So let's see, if I equip that sword, it's probably a lot heavier as well. Yeah, 81 I am now. What's the moveset? So, slashes and an overhead slam. If I two-handed, I have that dagger, which I can use to parry. That's the... What's that, actually? What's that actually doing? It doesn't seem to be a focus attack. It does use a lot of stamina. But I'm gonna see if I can't reinforce it. I think it's a pulse weapon, so I should be able to use... Or do I need to use Titanite Scales for that? Ah, yes, Titanite Scales and not Twinkling Titanite, because that's only for those, yeah, those unique weapons. I could actually do that as well. I'm kind of looking for something else to upgrade. The Pontiff Knight Curved Sword. It's cool because it has... Oh, it has that Frostblade attack. That's actually pretty cool, but... Yeah, I'm not going to for now. Too bad, actually, because... Would have been nice. Can I upgrade that to actually go to 100? Probably not, no. Okay. Nothing here then.
Pretty, be careful. I don't want to see.
I do want to check out Ludlit's inventory to see if he has anything new for me. Maybe a bit more interesting than that wolf's sword. Too bad I can't really effectively use that. Well, buff it, I mean. So let's go here and talk to Ludlit. So that's we've seen that. And what's new? This is new. Great Sword of Judgment. Stance of Judgment. A ceremonial sword held in Pontiff Sulyvahn's left hand. That was his dark sword then. Representing the judgment of the moon, but with magic far closer to sorcery than any existing lunar power. Its dark blue hues, deeper than the darkest moon, reflect Sorcerer Sulyvahn's true nature. So he was a sorcerer, and then profaned greatsword is probably the fire sword. A ceremonial sword held in Pontiff Sulyvahn's right hand, representing the profaned flame. Long ago, when Sulyvahn was yet a young sorcerer, he discovered a profaned capital, and an unfading flame below a distant tundra of Irritil, and a burning ambition took root within him, and the skill is a profaned flame. Temporarily summon the profaned flame, lunge forward and use strong attack to enshroud the blade in flame. That actually sounds amazing, but it's strength based, of course. I wonder if this... Yeah, so the other one, the Stance of Judgment, assume stance to unleash dark magic, use normal attack for a lunging thrust, and strong attack to emit side-sweeping wave. Sounds more useful to me. It scales with intelligence as well. So I'm gonna buy this one. Yeah, that's it for now. Thank you, Ludlit. I don't think we actually need to visit anyone else for now. So let's go back, because I am curious what lies ahead. So Pontiff Sulyvahn. And then let's see, just for a moment, what's behind this altar, this lovely looking altar. Because it looks... Oh, it's a mountainside, never mind, it looked like a... Like a mirror from behind. There's no items here as well, which is weird. I kind of hear... Okay. Now what? I hear a crystal lizard. That's two crystal lizards. Okay, let's go grab them then. Whoa, they're fast. Lost the other one. So that's one Twinkling Titanite. I think if I even just activate the bonfire and turn back, I'm gonna get the other one. So let's quickly do that. So let's just touch the bonfire. And get up again. And that should be enough to respawn the crystal lizards. And I can grab the other one. Seems to be something fancy over there as well. Oh! It didn't actually. May the flames guide thee. Well, there's not much to do here, so we had those crystal lizards over here. There's an item right here. Large titanite shards. And then maybe the other side. There's a staircase going up. I'm kind of torn between ending the episode and continuing on. Okay, so this isn't the end. Yeah, because that thing is even larger than this place. So yeah, I'm gonna end it here, because I'm presuming that Saint Aldrich is inside of that thing. Be wary of sniper. Yeah, there are those blue clerics over there, and a lot of dead giants. Well, I hope they're dead anyway. But hey, I'm gonna end the episode here, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate the support. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!